God has to take us through humility tests just to get our attention. Just to have us to wake up. Because some of us are asleep and don't realize we sleep.
That's right.
We sleep, don't realize we sleep.
Yeah.
Well, God's trying to get your attention. So he has to cause your friends to start tripping on you. Got to cause the car to break down.
Lord Jesus. My God.
Got to cause the boss man to start tripping. Hello? When you don't understand, because we are taught here that we are spirit beings.
Yes.
And everything is spiritual.
Yes.
So we have to understand that what God is doing, at the end of the day, God is in control. So, and we will be honest, sometimes too many of us, we get caught up in our emotions.
That's it.
We get caught up in our emotions. And what ends up happening is when we get caught up in our emotions, we end up making irrational decisions because we are emotional. So we shut down, we shut everything and everybody off,
yes.
Don't even talk to God, get mad at God, and then we're like, okay, what's up? Because we done cut everything off, because we're in our emotions. Get out of your feelings. Didn't I preach that one time before? I'm helping myself. Some of us, we too much in our feelings. Can't nobody tell us nothing.
That's right.
Anytime somebody try to share something with you.
Help me, Lord.
Quick to roll your eyes. The work of restoration, the burden, bearing, responsibility, caring, teaching, leading, and serving can take its toll on any spiritual life. Why? Because the enemy is going to be on his job.
Right.
But you can't get weary in your well-doing.
Mm-hmm.
You can't get bottled down. We are tempted to grow weary in our Christian lives when we have been criticized. Young people, everybody's not going to understand you.
Mm-hmm.
The Apostle Paul, again, let me take you to class real quick. How much of the Bible did he write?
Three fourths.
Make sure we're paying attention. Sunday school 101. Vacation Bible school. He wrote 3/4 of the Bible. Paul was not accepted. He was not accepted. Why? Because they thought that the man was crazy. He was not accepted. The people, they opposed him. Most of the Christians, when he wrote his letters to the church at Corinth, they thought that he was somebody else. They opposed him. They thought that Paul was not a powerful person. They just thought that the man was crazy. If you go and study in 1 and 2 Corinthians, when he wrote his letter to the church at Corinth, it is replica of the church of today. We gotta get this together. You got to work on it. You got to count it not strange. You got to be able to get in the face of God. So then when he writes his letter to the church at Corinth, he says, be not weary in well-doing.
Mm-hmm.
For when you are tempted to grow weary in Christian lives, when we have been criticized, sometimes the criticism will make you start listening to it. When you always got naysayers and negativity around you, sometimes you'll start listening to the negativity. That's why sometimes you have to tell your critics to shut up. Shut it on up. Or I'll holler at you. I'm out. I don't have time for it. Because when I'm getting ready to go, I have to leave baggage behind. You cannot go into your future with your past holding you down. So you got to let it go. The Bible says, forgetting those things which are behind, I got to press. I got to hasten to my clothes here. But we have to understand that we are tempted to grow weary. And when we are tempted to grow weary in our Christian lives, when we have been rejected, it is nothing but a trick of the enemy. Philippians chapter 3. But what things were to gain to me, those that I had counted a loss for Christ? Yea, doubtless, and I count all things but loss for the excellence of the knowledge of Christ Jesus, my Lord, for whom I have suffered the loss of all things, and do count them, but doing that I may win Christ. And he found in him, not having mine own righteousness, which is of the law, but that which is through the faith of Jesus Christ, the righteousness which is of God by faith, that I may know him, and in the power of his resurrection, and the fellowship of his sufferings, being made comfortable unto his death, if by any means I might attain unto the resurrection of the dead. Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing, somebody shout one thing.
One thing.
This one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth unto those things which are before. I press, somebody say I press.
I press
towards the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Some of us got to keep pressing. Some of us have gotten tired in our pressing. We've gotten tired in our pressing. So what do you do, Reed? What do you do? You always have to have some type of solution. Never present a problem if you don't present a solution. If you're a good leader, always present a solution before you name the problem. I don't got time to hear about the problem if you ain't gonna tell me a solution. So what do? Well, we keep it basic and we keep it simple. It's summertime. So my mind went back to when I was a kid growing up. What did we used to do when we was children growing up? Y'all don't do it no more. But during the summertime, we used to go to grandma's house and play outside.
Yes.
And what we did right about now, because it's the sun going down, but it's still out, right about now, we would play a game what we used to call hide and seek.
Yes.
Huh. Somebody help me. If that was a good place, we played hide and go seek. I ain't gonna do that. But we played a game called hide and go seek. We played little games called duck, goose. Y'all don't know anything about duck, goose. We played games like Mother May I.
Yeah.
We played games. I'm gonna tell y'all, our first shouting lesson was in hopscotch now.
Yeah.
That was where we learned how to dance in. Y'all don't do that. That was where we learned how to dance right there, hopscotch.
Yeah,
I don't play that no more. Or we play little games like
Red Rover.
By the time you grew up and became teenagers, you played another game, but we ain't gonna talk about that because we won't save it. So we thank God for the Lord saving us. But we learned how to deal with what we had. We didn't have money to go to the pool. We were talking about this the other day. We didn't have money to go to the pool. We took the water hose and we made it in the pool. That's what we did, okay? Y'all talking about slip and slides? We just took the water hose and sprayed the grass. That was our slip and slide. That's where you learn how to slide it in baseball right there. But y'all don't play those little games no more. Y'all don't play those games no more. But you would be amazed at the simplicity of these games, the revelation that you can get with them. So the game of hide and seek, the objective was you would pick a person, bubblegum in the ditch. How many pieces do you wish?
Three.
Put your foot in. If you didn't have many people, what you had to do? You had to put both feet in.
We used to do that right.
So I'm just trying to help us, but it's just in the simplicity of these games of hide and go seek. You had to go hide. You had to press in the count, and then you had to go hide. But it's in these games. You had to press in to go count. One, two, three.
Four.
Ready or not? Why is it when God said, ready or not, here I come, we get scared? We had to play a game called hide and go seek, though. And in us playing the game of hide and go seek, you always had a person who was it, but you always had another person who was always there. You always had that one person that they won't never touch, they won't never tag. Never tag. But in that, my mind went back to that because that was where we enjoyed a careless life.
Yes.
You know, that's when your knee got scraped up.
Yes.
And after you finished playing outside, we'd go in the house about 9 o'clock.
Yeah.
Street light come on.
Because street light was going to come on.
And your mama come.
And mama said, well, go in the house and bring that bath water. Mm-hmm. So you had to go in the house. Mama said, run that bathroom. When you go put that bathroom in that tub, put your little green alcohol in there. That's some joy because you ain't have real bubbles. That's some Epsom salt.
Come on.
But it was when you had already, in a child's like mine, you was doing good. And then when you got ready to go in the house, you went and relaxed. In a child's like mine, you was out there playing. You was doing good. Got tired, but you didn't get weary.
That's right. Yeah.
But when you got finished working, when you got finished working, you was able to turn around and rest and recharge and replenish for the next day. Because the next day, we had to go right back out and do it again. Y'all missed the revelation, y'all. If you are working and if you have the right mind, you won't get weary and you won't about being tired, and then you come in the house of God to get recharged, get replenished, and be able to go back out and do it again.
All right.
Right.
Why? Because we was working. Now and then, Grandmama told us we had to go and we had to help Grandmama because Grandmama had a flower bed.
Yes.
And you didn't play around Grandmama's flower bed. Unless you wanted a whoop. But it's in the simplicity of things, y'all. I'm getting to my clothes. Because in that, we didn't think about being tired. We just thought we was just having fun.
Yeah, that's right. Yes.
We was just having fun. We was working, we was playing, and that was it. Yeah. We went in the house, got a good home cooked meal. We didn't get McDonald's and Burger King and Wendy's and all that. We got a good home cooked meal.
Come on.
That's right.
Yes, sir.
We don't cook no more. Parents don't cook no more. The kids grow up on some of everything all the day. But in that, we had the right mind to be working, to enjoy life. And now here it is. God has said, okay, you've passed that. Now it's time to move on. I said all that to say, young people, as you begin to move from good to great, as you begin to grow up, as you begin to mature in certain things, God has his hand on your life. And yeah, that may sound very cliches. Mm-hmm. But when the hand of God is on your life, you're never going to fit in. Mm-hmm. You'll never be like everybody else.
That's right.
It won't be. It'll be just like trying to put a left shoe on a right foot.
Right.
It just won't happen. So what do? Three things, and I'll close. First thing is, you learn how to seek God's face and wisdom for yourself.
All right.
Many of us have grown up on the prayers of our parents
right.
and our grandparents. But there has to come a time where you have to grow up and develop it for yourself. Yeah. We must become disciples of Jesus. If we're going to do what he said, if you're going to do the will of God, you have to be able to know that God is going to bring you through. What is a disciple? A disciple is a student. So remember what I said, is that a good teacher is always a student. So be a student. Seek God for yourself. Number two, listen to know God's wisdom for our lives. Sometimes God will speak directly to you, but sometimes God will speak through the man of God. So we have to be able to receive the word. Don't sit and think that when pastors are preaching that he's not talking to me. Mm-hmm. Sometimes some of us can get so big-headed that can't nobody tell us nothing.
Right.
Can't nobody even share a word. But God said, listen. And then number three, you have to then turn around and apply what God said to do. Mm-hmm. Apply the word. Mm-hmm. The word will be so simple. It will be so simplistic that if you apply the word and do what God said to do, then everything else will work itself out. Mm-hmm. If you trust God.
Amen.
Stand up. I'm finished. But as we begin to move from good to great, it's not always going to make sense. It's not always going to add up. Everybody's not going to like you. So what? Some of us, we care too much about other people's opinions. Opinions are like noses.
Yeah.
Everybody got one. Everybody got one.
Right.
So, some of us, we need to get past our feelings, get past the opinions of others. I want to pray for these. So, in the summertime is when you, sometimes you can listen, we have a way over there for you. In the summertime is when you rest. You go to school for 180 days. If you go to school every day, which you should be. But you're in school for time. You got friends. Teachers teaching. We're working. We're working hard to do what we got to do so that you can take a test. Then to be able to attain that knowledge. But the thing is, you have to take the knowledge that you've already gained and use it in the next grade. Because it builds. So some of us, we have our problems. We have our perplexities. We have our troubles. Some of us don't like to read. Some of us struggle at reading. Some of us struggle in algebra. Some of us struggle in biology. Some of us struggle in social studies. Whatever have us, some of us struggle with that. But in it, God is always going to have your back. You will have to have the blood of Jesus covering. Parents, I petition you every day to cover your children. If they eat breakfast at the house, cover your children. Cover your children. Why? Because in these last and evil days, it is such a necessity.
Right.
So as you begin to move from good to great, the enemy is going to try to throw everything at you. Friends going to start tripping. All your friends that you had in middle school, ninth grade, 10th grade, whatever have you, they're going to be tripping. True, right? Because God has called you great. If you're in this house, if you are a son or daughter of this house, you are great.
Hallelujah. 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 And I do agree with that word. We have to press towards something greater, but we are great. So we got to keep on pushing toward the mark of the high calling, which is in Jesus. And I believe that he's going to bless us, God, even through the things that we've been through, even the things that we had to deal with. I believe in the end, it's going to be worth it all.
Amen.
Well, let's stand.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God, we thank you, God, for this night, God. God, we thank you, God, for everything that was brought forth with your word. God, we ask that you, even now, God, touch us, God. God, touch every young person, God, that came tonight to attend to your service, God. Even now, God, even the adults that came, God, give us strength now, God, in the name of Jesus, God, as we go to work, God, in our places of business, God, in the name of Jesus, God. God, we pray strength, God, to our bodies, God, even as we sleep, God. We pray your peace of God that surpasses all of our understanding, God, that shall guide our minds through Christ Jesus, God. Touch us now, God. Dismiss us from this place, but never from your presence, God. Go with us and be with us to the next appointed time. In Jesus' name, we pray.